Welcome you all to the new video. Today in this video, we are going to learn about a new technique called hashing. And before proceeding to the method of hashing, let me tell you something that why do we need this hashing, or where in the real life situation we actually require this method of hashing. Okay, proceeding directly to the example. Let us consider the student details. And the student details include four things. That is their register number, their name, their ages, and their addresses. So all these four parameters are collected from a collection of students. And each record of student is to be collected and thereafter had to be stored within the computer memory. What did I say? I have to collect the details of the students. And the collected details need to be stored in the memory. So it can be represented like this. From the user, the details are collected. Thereafter, the collected details can be stored in the memory or can be termed as they are stored in the database. Similarly, user can do one more activity. He can also retrieve the details from the database. That means the data which was already stored in the database can be retrieved. And the retrieved data can be presented before the user. So he can perform two activities. Either he can store new details to the database, or he can retrieve the existing details from the database. And these two activities, storage and retrieval, can be performed with the help of hashing. So why do we need hashing? Hashing is used for easy retrieval, or we can say for fast retrieval of data, we can use hashing. Second point is that for easy and fast storage of data, we can also use hashing. And hashing also promotes better memory management. So these are the advantages of the method hashing. So what is hashing? Hashing is a technique that can be used to store and retrieve data faster and easier in a convenient way from the database. Okay, so let us see how this can be done. To perform a hashing, we require a hash algorithm. What do we require? We require a hash algorithm. Okay, so this algorithm is capable of performing hashing. Now, what is the input of this algorithm? This algorithm receives an input from the user. And the input of the algorithm is known as key. Okay, and what is the output of the algorithm? Output is an address, and the address is known as a hash address. So now let me tell you the definition of hash algorithm. Hash algorithm is capable of doing hashing, which accepts a user input known as key, and after accepting the input from the user, it does some processing. And as a result of processing, it produces an output which is a hash address. Now, what is this hash address? Hash address means where in the memory the details of particular record are to be stored. That means if I am collecting the details of student number 1, then 1 will be the input to the hash algorithm. And the algorithm gives you the address where the details of first student will be stored in memory. Later, when the second student details are given to the algorithm again produces another address where the details will be stored. So for each input to the algorithm, algorithm produces a separate address to which the details had to be stored. So hope the concepts are clear. Each time, whenever you give the input, that is the key value, algorithm receives the key value and produces an address in the memory where the details of the student had to be stored. Okay, now what about this address? Hash address is associated with hash table. What is this hash table? Hash table is a memory area where the details will be stored. Another important thing is that hash table consists of continuous locations. Okay, so we take continuous locations together, and the collection of these continuous locations are termed as hash table. It is purely a memory area. A continuous section of memory is known as a hash table. Within the hash table, the data will be stored. Total number of records that can be stored in the data is known as hash size. So what is hash size? It is the maximum capacity of the hash table. Suppose the hash size is 10. It indicates that to the maximum only 10 records can be stored in the hash table. And if the hash size is 100, it indicates that at the maximum 100 records can be stored in the hash table. So depending on the hash size, hash table tells how many records can it store continuously. So these are continuous memory locations. So now you know these terms. I repeat. Initially, the hash algorithm is used to perform hashing. And for performing hashing, the algorithm accepts an input from the user, and this input is known as key. After accepting the input, the hash algorithm performs some processing over it and produces an address to which the details should be stored. This address corresponds to hash table. Hash table is a continuous allocations of memory locations. And the maximum capacity of hash table is labeled as hash size. Let us see how the inputs will be accepted and how addresses will be generated so that the information will be stored in the hash table. Suppose we have 100 records. That means we need to store the details of 100 students. Every student detail will be treated as one record. So, details of 100 students means we have 100 records. So, to store the details of 100 records, we require 100 memory locations. What did I say? To store the details of 100 students, we require continuous 100 locations. So we must define a hash table such that the size of the hash table is 100. So that in this hash table, continuously 100 student records can be stored. Clear? Now, what is this key? You know one thing, that key is an input given to the algorithm. What kind of input? We know that in the example above, there were four values associated with the student. That means name, number, age, and address. Out of these four values, which field can be termed as a key field? Name, can it be a key field? No, because many students can have same name. So name field cannot be used as a key field. What about age? Can age be used as a key field? No, age cannot be used as a key field because ages of students can also be same. What about the address field? Addresses of students can be same, may or may not be same. We cannot say that they will be unique. So key field should be selected in such a way that it is a field which has a unique value in it. You have to select a field which accepts only unique values. That means for every record, that particular field will be having different values. The field which never has any duplicate values in it will be selected as the key field. So in this particular example, we can select the key field as the first field, that is the number or the register number. So the register number for every student will be definitely different. So here in this particular example, the key field which we are going to select is the register number or the roll number. Okay. Now let us see how the address can be generated. For the time being, I am taking the hash size as 10. And this is hash size. Hash size means maximum capacity of the hash table. Okay. For the time being, I have taken size of the table as 10. That means at the maximum only 10 student details can be stored in the table. Now let us see how the address can be generated. And the equation for generating address is hash address. H address means hash address. Hash address is equal to key mod hash size. The value of key mod hash size. Okay. What is the operator mod means? Operator mod means you have to divide the value of key by hash size and the remainder is to be collected. Okay, divide the value of key by hash size and collect the remainder. So this is a division operator which gives the output as remainder. Okay, and that value will be treated as the address. Okay, so let us see what were the different key values. The different key values were 14, 11, 12 and 13. Okay, so first of all, let me give the value 11. I'm going to enter the details of Neha. So since I wish to enter the details of Neha, I am going to give the key value as 11 because that is only the unique field which will never repeat. Okay, so I'm going to give the key value as 11. Let us see if I'm giving the key value as 11, which address will be generated where the details of Neha will be stored in the memory. Okay, so I'm going to give the key value as 11. So when key is 11, the address will be generated as H address, that is hash address is equal to key, which is 11, mod hash size, which is 10. 11 mod 10 means 11 will be divided by 10 and the remainder will be collected. What is the remainder? Remainder is 1. Okay, so I have given the input as 11. What was the input? Input was 11, which is the key value. Okay, so when I gave the key value to the hash algorithm had given me an address, which is 1. This indicates that the details of the person who is having the register number as 11 will be stored in the first memory location of the hash table. So the details of record 11 will be stored in the first memory location of the hash table. Wherever in the memory the hash table starts, that particular hash table's first location will be allocated to the details to be stored for the record of 11. Let us see what happens if another value is given. This time I wish to give the value 14. Let us see who is 14. So this time when the key is 14, I am going to store the details of Ravi. Let us see where in the memory the details of Ravi will be stored. Okay, so I'm going to give the value of key as 14. When key is given as 14, algorithm accepts the key value, does some processing and generates the address using this equation. Hash address is equal to key mod hash size. That is key is 14, hash size is 10. So 14 mod 10 will give you the value 4. That means Details of Ravi will be stored in the hash table at its fourth memory location. Okay, so in this way, you can give the key value for each record. Whichever key value will be given to the hash algorithm after processing will give you an address of the hash table where it is to be stored. Okay, so from this it is clear that the details of roll number 11 will be stored in memory location 1. Details of roll number 14 will be stored in the memory location 4 and as such. Okay, let me draw it in a pictorial way. So this was typically our hash table. It is having number of locations in it. And to find which record will be stored in which memory location, I wish to use an algorithm. The purpose of algorithm is to find where in memory the details of records will be stored. Okay, and this algorithm is known as a hash algorithm. Hash algorithm accepts the input which is known as key value, a value of the details which will never repeat for different persons. A unique field will be selected as a key field, which is accepted by the algorithm, and the algorithm finds the address and tells you where in the memory the details are to be stored. Remember, this hash table is a continuous allocation of memory. In this way, hash algorithm can be used to find the memory address where the details of students are to be stored. Similarly, what can be done if I wish to retrieve the details? Method is same. Once all the details are stored in the hash table, and later if you wish to retrieve the same details, you have to give again the same key value. Whichever key value will be given to the hash algorithm will generate a corresponding address, and from that address the details can be retrieved easily. Remember, which algorithm is used to store the details to the hash table, the same algorithm has to be used to retrieve the details from the hash table. So same algorithm is used for storing as well as retrieving details. So later, if I am giving a value 14 and I wish to retrieve the details of the student number 14, the key will be given to the algorithm. Algorithm does a processing and finds the address as 4. Then I can read the details from the address 4. And address 4 or location 4 will give me the details of the person who is having the roll number 14. In this way, same algorithm can be used to store the details to the hash table as well as to retrieve the details from the hash table. And this is a quite fast and easiest method of storing. And a method in which hash table and hash algorithms are used to find the locations in memory where the details are to be stored, the whole process is known as hashing. Hope the concepts are all clear to you. Keep watching the videos and support me. Please subscribe the channel if you are not yet subscribed.